Hello viewer, welcome to Science Hub. My name is Simon Ongwa, a Form 1 student from the Corner Brook School. We are going to learn about natural numbers. As you can see, it's Form 1 to pick 1 natural numbers. Natural number, also known as counting numbers, consists of 0 to 9. It's 0, 1, 2, 3, continuity up to 9. A number, a digit may have a different value of its position in a number. A digit may have a different value because of its position in a number. For example, let's take an example of digit 2, 4, 5, and 9. These are digits, but they have different values. For example, this is in the value of 1, this is in the value of 10, 100, thousands. This takes us to the subtopic of natural numbers called place value. What is place value? Place value is the position of a digit in the number. For example, if you can see 2, 4, 5, 9. These are digits, but they have different values. And this is what we call the place values. Then you go to subtopic total value. What is total value? Total value is the product of the place value and the digit. For example, 2, 4, 7, and 8. These are digits. And as you said, total value is the product of the place value and the digit in a number. So the total value of 7, it is 7 multiplied by its place value, of which it is 1 10, so times 10, which we get 70. And this 70 is the total value of 7. In natural numbers, we've said that 0 to 9, they are called natural numbers. But sometimes in total values, 0 is not considered as a whole number. Why? If you take 2, 4, 0, 8, 9, suppose you ask to get the total value of 0, what will you write? It is 0 times the place value of 0 is 1, 10, 100 times 100. You'll get 0. So sometimes 0 is not considered as a natural number when you're writing total value. When given a number to write in ones, for example, 7897. When you're given a number like this to write in ones, you first divide it into 3. 1, 2, 3, using commas. Then find the place value of the first digit, which is 1, 10, 100, 1000. So this will be 7,800 and 97. It's always good when you're given numbers to first divide them into threes using commas. You may be given a large number like 68, 79, 32, 1. It's good always to divide the number into threes using commas. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you always know that this number, the value of 6 is million. So you are not going to write 6,000, you are going to write 6,000,000. Then that proceeds. We go to the subtopic rounding off. Rounding off. Then, what is rounding off? This writing the number in simple form. Start rounding off. This writing the number in simple form. So that it may, and it may not confuse people. For example, suppose the 2019 census will be represented as will be 68,789,321. This number could be estimated as 68 million. What do you learn? Rounding off is all to do with estimation. We are just estimating this number to be 68 million. And this takes us to the steps followed in rounding off. When you are given a number to round off to the nearest mentioned number, for example, you can be told to round this number to the nearest tens, hundreds, thousands, millions. The first step in rounding off is always to underline the place, the digit in the question. For example, you are told to round this number to the nearest thousands. You count ones, tens, hundred, thousands. And this takes us to the subtopic, rounding off. If this number could be the census of 2019, the 2019 census, it could be simply estimated as 69 million. And this takes us to the steps followed in rounding off. For example, 68,789,321. And you're told to round off this number to the nearest thousands. The first step is to underline the digits in the question. And what is the digit in the question? The digit in the question is thousands. So ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. You underline this number. The second step is to circle the digit on the right of the underlined number, this number. Then you consider the digits, the circle digit is in the first group of numbers, of which the first group is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the first group of numbers when rounding off. Then you have 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. This is the second group of rounding off. Or what you call, if it is more than half of 10, or it is less than half of 10. The second digit, if it is in the second group of numbers, or it is more than half of 10, of which half of 10 is 5, you are going to add one to the underlying digit. So it will be if it is in the second group. Suppose the second number was 5, you could add plus 1. But since it is in the first group, 3 is in the first group, you're only going to add 0. So the number will be 68,789,000. The numbers, the digits on the right of the underlined number changes to zeros, and the digits on the left of the underlined number, they change their values. As you can see, 3, 2, 1 is on the right of the underlined number, which is, of the underlined digit, which is 9. They've changed it to 0. And the numbers on the left, and the digits on the left of the underlined number, they've retained their value. And this, the next step, we are going to do operation on whole numbers. On word problems, talk about word problems. One must read the given information carefully and divide the operations required
the lesson should be represented and in an orderly manner.
For example,
a minibus has 23 passengers at the beginning of a journey.
You are supposed to arrange your work well.
A minibus has 23 passengers at the beginning of a journey.
True. This is the beginning of a journey. That's 23 passengers.
12 passengers are alighted at the first stop.
The first stop. At the beginning of the journey, we had 23 passengers, but 12 alighted at the first stop. So it will be 23. It will be 23 minus 12. You get 11. So here we have 11 passengers remaining in the bus.
Twelve passengers alighted at the first stop. While 9 boarded the bus.
So it is 11. It will be 11 plus 9, 20. So the bus already 12 alighted and 9 boarded.
The bus now has 20 passengers. 6 of those who boarded at the first stop alighted at the second stop.
The second stop. We have 6. It is 20 minus 6. We remain with 40 passengers.
Six of those who boarded at the first alighted at the second stop and 12 got in.
So it is 14, it will be 14 plus 12, which is 26.
And the second stop and 12 got in. The minibus did not stop again up to the final
destination. So at the final destination, we had 26. It's always good when you're given information, to arrange it in an orderly manner, till you have done it.
And the charges from the starting point were 50 shillings up to the first stop.
So from here to the first stop, whoever was in the bus paid 50 shillings.
The charges from the starting one, 50 shillings up to the first stop, 7 up to the second stop, and 85 up to the final destination.
So from here up to here it's 50. From the first stop to the second stop it is 70 shillings. From the second stop up to the final destination we have 85 shillings. Then you ask, how much did they pay altogether? It's always good. If you arrange your information like this, you'll only take 23 times 50. You take 70 times 20. You take 85 times 26. Then you get up the question. You get the question right. If you ask the total amount that they contributed, it will be simple. If you arrange your information like this, it will be 23 times 5. 5. And 1 to 11, 5. 7 times 2 will get 14 and 2 zeros, 1400. It will be 85 times 26, 0, carry 3. It is 8 times 6, 14 plus 3 will get 1, 0, carry 1, it will be 17, 0, 1, 2, 2. Then you sum up to be 2 2 10 1 4 0 0 0 1 6 3 1 1 5 0 0 6 7 4, and get your answer correct. This brings me to the end of this discussion. Welcome to Science Hub, LMTV. Keep it, watch it, and learn. Thank you.